David, you're the VP of Software Development at GeoJoe.
That's right.
So do you want to tell me a little bit about your role there?
Yeah, so Vice President of Software Development at GeoJoe, and I'm also the Director of our Center for Research and Engineering, which we do a lot of our productized application development, a lot of our services work around application development as well. So, you know, anything such as admin tools, Mapfolio, you know, and any of our partnerships with the startups. Recently when we came out with MapLabs, my office and everything primarily handles that, and it's part of the whole GeoJoe ecosystem where we provide products and services around the platform.
Okay. So what would you say are going to be the top like three things that will be coming out of GeoJoe over the next 6 months to a year? Can you share a bit of that?
Yeah, so that's a tough question. I'm going to do my best to answer that without giving away too much information, too much of the secret sauce there. Yeah, so I reckon I'd have to say there's going to be a lot of growth around our admin tools, you know, product suite, particularly on the admin tools for portal portion. I can tell that, you know, with Esri really in pushing out this philosophy of the portal of portals and the idea of collaborative sharing across multiple, there's going to be more and more content, more and more data that's going to need to be managed. I think that's going to be something is the expansion there. Particularly know that we're doing in that kind of expansive area of portal management, more tag management is something our users have asked for a while. I know in admin tools we'll be releasing some more folder concept related filters and queries and things that you can do there. It's something that's been asked for a while. A second thing I would have to say is we're really, really excited about an idea of working around being able to have tool sets that are useful for backing up your organization, any type of disaster recovery. And that's to say, you know, you're already in the cloud, which is great. You're insulated from risk there, a lot of risk mitigation. But sometimes, whether it's malicious or just a mistake, someone goes in and deletes something and then you realize maybe 6 months down the road that, hey, you really needed that. So if someone mistakenly, you know, deletes a feature service or, you know, mistakenly makes a whole bunch of edits that just wrecks a data set, then you know, you can kind of prevent that personnel damage that was done to the data by having a restore point. And the final thing I'd have to say is a little bit more bigger, if I have to come up with three, is kind of putting our toe in the water and really kind of jumping in a little bit with machine learning. I think that's something we're really going to expand in the next year. And you know, in various ways, some supervised machine learning and unsupervised machine learning, primarily probably starting out around you know, related to the other things I spoke of. So maybe the neural network's aware of like common tags that you use or common filters. We can embrace that, use it, and it creates a simpler user experience because we're all about the power of GIS simplified.
Perfect. Okay, so recently we've been hearing a lot about 10.5.
Yeah.
And getting schooled on that. So when it comes to the platform, yeah. What's the company's philosophy?
Yeah, we fully embrace the platform, you know, whether that be through ArcGIS Online or through ArcGIS for Enterprise with your own portal on-premise taking place there. The entire web mapping platform is something that we feel is good for the industry. It's great for humanity. More and more people are actually going to embrace that platform, so get more, you know, more users that probably are not traditional geospatial individuals. That's just going to grow. It's going to blossom into more content, better decision-making, better understanding of our world. And that's really also, you know, Esri has the tagline, the science of where. And that's really what it's going to come down to, is that better understanding of our world through the science of where. And that's going to happen all because of the modern platform. And GeoJoe is going to be part of that. We're going to be leading it. And we're going to, you know, do our best, do everything we can to make that philosophy even more into a reality and even more part of our day-to-day lives.
Thanks. Okay, so speaking of that, it sounds like a lot of work.
It is.
Right, you got your work cut out for you. So plans for growing the team?
Yeah, definitely. So GeoJoe, you know, there's always a balance in software development between, you don't want to grow too fast, you know. You want everyone on the team to be valuable. We have members of the team that have come in as junior developers and worked their way all the way up. We have some amazing talent that has come directly on board that already had a weight of knowledge and information, experience, and learning behind them. And I think over the next you know, over the next year to year and a half, I'll probably see some fairly rapid growth on the team, you know, and not just on my team, but all across GeoJo. I know there's some expansion on the UAV and the UAS side with some great work that Neil Jobe, our founder, is doing. I know that our GeoPowered Cloud, which is our data hosting solution, is growing all the time. So it's not just you know, the ambitiousness of our software development dreams that's going to drive the growth of hiring, but also it's these other verticals based around UAV and based around data hosting. And I really believe that those are three strong points, to kind of circle it back to the platform, three strong points of that can be seen as pillars of the platform: putting data in through UAV US, making sure that data is, you know, processable, make sure it's accessible, and make sure that you have the machine power to, you know, do additional things with it. It's our GeoPowered Cloud. And then enabling the users to do more and simplifying it is our software development at that point, and creating those focused applications that solve focused problems. So yeah, we'll definitely be hiring and expanding.
So something, a term that I've heard coming out of you even recently is the concept of geo-mentorship.
Oh, yes.
Right? So how are you involved in, you know, when it comes to geo-mentorship and GeoJo as well?
Yeah, so, you know, on the company level, we have the Map This initiative, which is great. It's based around bringing more geographic awareness, bringing education. I think it's a fun brand that a lot of people get behind. And, you know, I'd have to say there's a great, you know, that product line and that brand directly goes towards sponsoring geo-mentorship. It goes towards working with young individuals who are going to grow in the spatial sciences. On a personal level, I've been involved with, I spoke at the YPN at last year's UC at a panel of the Young Professionals Network. I believe that's a great thing that Esri's doing in geo-mentorship, taking those who have a lot of experience, depth of experience in the field, putting them in contact with people who may just now be starting out, who may just be, you know, maybe a few years into their career, and doing some knowledge transfer and some mentorship. I personally also, you know, do university lecturing a good bit, and the local high school, I interact with them. They have a great GIS program at Gulfport High School down in Gulfport, Mississippi, and I go there and, you know, speak to the classes about the reality of the situation in spatial sciences and the growth potential and the career field potential, and also even partner-to-partner, there's geo-mentorship going on. We work a lot with startups that may be, you know, very ambitious and have great ideas, incredibly intelligent people, and all they're missing for complete success is maybe an embracement of the platform in a way, and understanding this market, which is the traditional GIS market. And GeoJo has that history there. GeoJo has that brand. They have that recognition. So we'll work with startups. We'll do, in that case, you know, they don't necessarily need geo-mentorship in the classic sense, but what we can provide there is the value add of the expertise of the platform. So, you know, everything from, then, and I'll tell you what else, is GeoJo gets a lot of geo-mentorship from other individuals also, right? I mean, we learn a lot from Esri and the people we interact there. I mean, I owe an absolute debt of gratitude to Bern, the Esri team, to Bernie. I mean, great guy. He's always helped me understand, you know, how to manage brand, how to do marketing, you know. And I'll tell you, even inside of the company, you know, Neil Jobe has done a lot of geo-mentorship with me and helped me grow with my philosophy, my way of looking at the industry, and understanding how best to, you know, basically kind of like come up with a strategy and a plan of attack. And, you know, so I think we're all learning from each other. A lot of geo-mentorship all around. So.
Nice. All right. So, excuse me. So with that, let's looking at the industry down the road, you know, the next 5, 10, and 25 years, what do you think we can expect, and you know, how does GeoJo fit into that too?
Yeah. Well, the first thing I have to say, I think, about that is you ask very hard questions. So you know, I think in the next 5 years we're going to see a lot of portal-to-portal collaboration. You know, and I think GeoJo's fit there makes a lot of sense, right? So as there's more and more data, there's more information being shared, I think that our administrative tools, our tagging tools, I think all of that's going to make sense. I think for GeoJo also, there's this explosion of growth in UAV UAS, where I think that more portals, we're going to see more and more data brought in. I think we're going to be seeing a lot of business intelligence and big data analysis, the ability for really smart people to tap into this really complex data and find patterns and be able to tell good stories with it. I think in the next 10 years, people might call me crazy, but I think that even what I just said is going to be augmented very heavily by machine learning, by neural networks, that what we're going to see is that big data, all that information, there may be patterns that may not be obvious to the human eye, but where a neural network is going to totally make sense to it. It's going to take seemingly unrelated data set A and unrelated data set B that's both inside of the platform, be able to compare them and come out with something great. That would be my hope. That would be my dream of it, you know. And 25 years, I mean, the sky's the limit. I don't even know where we'll be there. It seems like technology and the progress is just,
it
so
rapid. Like an eternity away.
Who knows? I mean, let's see, 25 years ago, what was going on? That was 1990, do I even have my year right? Was that 1992? You were in 2017?
Yeah, 92.
92, I mean, think about how far the internet's come since 92. So think of how far GIS has come in 25 years. It's exciting, you know? And I know just the growth I've seen in my time in the industry is absolutely amazing. I mean, I got in the 3-2 days, and now we're, you know, went all the way through Arc IMS to Arc Server. I mean, probably the youngest person you know is a certified Avenue developer. So it just so what I've seen in this period of time has just been absolutely phenomenal.
Okay, last thing. I'll throw you a curveball.
All right, well, so there you go.
Tell me something I don't know about GeoJoe.
Oh, okay. Well, you work for us, like the general viewer? Like the general, like someone watching this video, what they might not know, or like kind of like that?
Yeah, I mean, okay. A lot of folks in the industry are familiar with GeoJoe.
Yeah.
But,
well, I'll tell you, you know, I hit on it twice in this video, but I'm going to say it's probably, I think a lot of people are familiar with, you know, with our admin tools, with our software development. I think those are familiar territory for people when it comes to associating GeoJoe with that. I think there's a crowd that really understands our geo-powered cloud and how that augments the platform and kind of the role and the fit there and how powerful that could be if you want all that power of the platform, you know, all the power of Arc Server, but you don't want to necessarily manage your own Arc Server. I think some people know about that, but this emerging vertical inside of GeoJoe around the drones, I think that's what something that maybe someone who classically is involved in interactive GeoJoe, that's new territory for us. So we're working on the messaging around that, we're working on talking about that, but you know, I mean, I'll tell you just a couple of weeks ago, there was some work done by that team where they went and did a structure scan of a certain facility to calculate the insurable, you know, rate of that facility, basically. And I think that's like just this whole new territory, this whole new thing that maybe the GeoJoe brand isn't fully established with, but I think that as it progresses, you know, it's gonna be one of those things that people really associate with GeoJoe. It's top quality, top of the line UAV drone work. That's going to be part of it. So.
Awesome, nice. All right, thanks, David. I appreciate
Thank you.
It.